here in Ann Arbor, Michigan. The store has been here for 3 years. It will be our birthday on February 1st, and I'm excited to be part of the downtown Ann Arbor community and part of the Michigan and Metro Detroit area for brides to choose their gowns. So 2014 is bringing on a lot of fun new trends that we are not necessarily used to seeing, especially with some of the designers that we carry. There are a lot more sleeved options as well as strapped options. You know, I felt like the designer's collections that we saw from the last two seasons pretty much were a 50-50 on the strapless and the non-strapless. So that's exciting for the girls who are seeking the non-strapless gowns. The low V fronts, low V backs are very popular, as well as the high necks. Even with just having seen the Golden Globes recently, you saw a lot of high necks, low backs, and we saw that in bridal as well from this past season, so that was exciting. Ball gowns as well, is seeing some nice fuller skirts that girls, I think for a while, tended to, you know, just do the trumpet and just do the mermaid, but seeing that fuller skirt come back is exciting. Things to go into knowing before choosing your gown. Start with both the date and the venue. And with that, maybe knowing, you know, a color palette that you wanted to stay within, specifically if you're okay with wearing white, or, you know, you want to stick to the ivory, the blushes, the champagnes, and going a little bit outside the box. So usually that ties in with the date and the venue, but also ties into having it match your personal style on an everyday basis. I think that's really important. You don't know when you're going to put on that magical dress, and whoever you want to really be here with you, whether it's your maid of honor, or your mom, or your grandma, have them with you throughout the shopping experience. But with that too, is plan your shopping experience. Just like, you know, you're planning everything else in the wedding, don't just pick 5 stores and say, I'm going to go to these 5 stores. You know, pick the 3 stores that you know really have what you're looking for, whether they match, again, your personal style, whether, you know, looking at the boutique, you've heard great reviews about them, that's great, you've had friends who shopped here, you know, we love that when we know that you knew a former bride or you're a sister of a former bride, that's really exciting to us, and we like knowing when you come in, why are you shopping here? Do you know that, you know, your favorite designer is with us? Do you know because you've walked by our window a million times and love every dress you've seen in there? You know, we want to know that we're the right fit for you. So, and that's, I would say, across the board with any bridal store, you want to make sure going into it that you pick maybe those 3 bridal stores that are the right fit for you, and you have all of those key people there with you when you're shopping. And that way it doesn't make it that overwhelming process, but more of an overall experience. Generally speaking, the dresses should be ordered anywhere between, you know, 6 to 12 months. Dresses for our designers can take anywhere between 4 to 6 months to be produced and come in. And so that 6 to 12 months just allows that extra leeway time for obviously the alteration process, just having it here. When I started the store 3 years ago, it was important for me to have a lot of designers that were based and designed their merchandise in US. So with that, we were able to do a lot more of the customizations. Also specifically with nearly almost all of our designers, a few of them are also carried elsewhere, but we are the only retailer in the state of Michigan, which is really fun. So we do offer, you know, kind of more of an exclusive selection. You know, it's not stuff that you see all over the place. You're not gonna see it with, you know, the bride walking down the aisle next weekend. You know, we're really big on, even with that, accessorizing very differently. And all of the accessories that we carry here are designers that are based in, you know, do their design and production in the US, which again is very important. Shoes are important for a couple different reasons. When you're ordering, it is nice to know a heel height that you would like to stay within. It's not necessarily, you know, a must know when you're ordering your gown, but with some of the designers that we have here at the Gown Shop, we can do custom cuts and custom fits, which is really nice to be able to offer to a bride. However, with that, you need to know usually the heel height. It doesn't have to be the exact shoe, but you need to know if you want to do a 3-inch heel or 4-inch heel, if you want to be in flats. You know, knowing that is helpful and just allows for the alteration process to be maybe a little bit less of a process, I guess. But before, you know, if you order your dress in the standard length, that's fine too. It's just before you get into the alterations, you will have to pick your shoe. We have a great shoe selection here of two different designers that our brides really love, one of which has like a Nike foam technology, so they're super comfy. And the other ones are fun because you can dye them any color. So I know, you know, you're seeing a lot more with like the fun blue shoe underneath or a shoe that matches, you know, the color of the wedding. So I've been really excited about the shoes that we offer, and a lot of our brides end up choosing the shoes that we have here just because they're able to try them on throughout the try-on process of their gowns and kind of pick between different styles too. So with brides who are looking to have a destination wedding, I think, you know, the big advice is don't make it, you know, a lot of times the destination is a beach. That doesn't mean that you can only do a super simple beach wedding dress. Choose the gown that still fits your personal style is my go-to recommendation for that. You probably don't want a huge ball gown, but maybe it's a ball gown that has, you know, really flowy layers, so it still works on the beach. But as far as, you know, getting it there and flying and, you know, usually if we're able to assist you in the process of shipping and you're comfortable with that, we usually do that for a lot of our brides. Being in Ann Arbor, we have found that we have a lot of brides who do destination weddings, whether it be, you know, flying and being on a beach, or if it's just New York or North Carolina or California. And in that case, we're able to help them with the shipping process. But usually, from what I've seen and what I hear, the process of getting it on and off the plane is fairly easy. I mean, it will have to be, you know, used as a carry-on piece for you, but usually the flight attendants will put it in the pilot's closet, usually. So that's what I've heard, and usually that's like the best thing. You know, they're excited. They're excited that you're gonna be on the plane and you're getting married, so use that to your advantage. The experience that we offer here at the Gown Shop is a little bit different than I think what most bridal stores have, which has always, you know, been my dream for them to have that experience, you know, coming into here. So what we like to do is we do require appointments here at the store, and that's to ensure that we have that private one-on-one time with them when they shop here and with their group. We do a little bit of research, like I had mentioned with them before, as far as, you know, what their wedding's going to be like, the budget that they want to stay within. We do have two different bridal suites that kind of house different price points, so we like to have that general information with them first. And then pretty much after that, once they walk through the door, you know, it's a fun greeting and good time to get to know each other, you know, reconnect again as far as those guidelines that we had gone over prior to them coming in. And then we start with picking dresses for the brides to kind of, you know, based on what they told us, and then just pretty much dive into the trying on process, you know, and then narrow it down from there and do the fun accessories at the end of the appointment. And hopefully, if it's her dream dress, do the fun, you know, purchasing appointment and, you know, taking the photos of her and taking photos with the group. And, you know, going through that process is really great. And if the girls like to come back to do the accessories, that's always another fun appointment time for them too.
Thank you so much for watching this episode of Jessica's Wedding Guide. I want to thank Stacy Fork, owner of the Gown Shop, for sitting down with me, taking the time to answer all of these questions so that we could kind of relay all of it to you guys, the ones planning your wedding out there. For more info on the Gown Shop, you can visit www.thegownshopannarbor.com. You should definitely take the opportunity to get in touch with Stacy and be able to see some of their beautiful dresses. I was in awe in that store. I just wanted to have everything. And for more information on us, you can visit www.janiefusion.com. You can check out our blog, view our images, see some of our video work, and have fun with that. So stay tuned, because we plan to bring you more episodes with local vendors who can give you lots of great ideas about planning your wedding, what to expect, maybe some tips, and hopefully that'll help you throughout your entire planning process. I hope you enjoyed this episode of Jessica's Wedding Guide, and happy planning.